首先，我向我的神圣的灵性导师尼特利拉马乌斯塔欧米什努巴阿斯托特西什玛巴迪兰达纳莱尼古沙尼玛拉吉莲花主自由恭敬的礼拜。其次呢，我向我的灵性指导者们保护者们的礼拜。
Shiva Premananda Prabhu Brahmachari
Shiva Bhaktivedanta Tirtha Maharaj
Shiva Bhaktivedanta Tirtha Maharaj
and Shiva Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj
Shiva Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj
and they are nourishing me my relationship with Gurudev
那么他们滋养了我跟Shri Gurudev的关系
And they're protecting me to help me follow the order of my guru.
那么他们帮助我去呢，追寻呢我guru的训练。
In spite of so many opposition,
尽管有很多反对的意见。
I know that they're helping me fulfill the order of my guru.
但是呢，我知道他们帮助我呢去呢实现我guru的这个命令训练。
And I want to offer my obeisances to all my god brothers and god sisters.
我向所有在座的神兄弟姐妹呢，去自由恭敬的礼拜。
Also, I want to offer obeisances to Jamuna. Say it.
大家杨木呢？杨木的礼拜。
And she's probably been exposed by so much, you know, opposition. But never it has been told that to speak Harikatha is aparat.
但是呢，讲经呢，绝对不是一种冒犯。讲Harikatha。
Actually, it's been told that if anybody stops you from speaking Harikatha, this is aparat.
那么实际上任何人反对别人讲哈利卡塔呢才是的真正的冒犯。
So anyhow, thank you for translating. Because without you, I couldn't be able to speak. So in this way, I wanted to speak about Shrimad Bhagavatam.
那么现在我开始想讲一点关于圣典不讲的。
And I'm just trying to repeat what I heard from my guru then.
我呢是的去重复呢我从古殿那里听到的东西。
And because this is his order to me.
那么这也是他对我的一个训练。
Repeatedly.
就是说他一直在重复的跟我这样说过。
More than 10 times he gave me this instruction.
那么超过十次呢他给了我这个训示。
To preach his mission around the world.
去呢在全世界呢传播这个使命。
He would get very angry.When I would stay in the dump room by them.
如果呢我呢想留在呢这个dump就圣地呢做巴掌的话做我的灵修，他要生气的
And he would tell me, why aren't you preaching?
他会说呢，为什么你不出去传教
？I've given you so much. Why haven't you come and give it to others?
我已经给了你很多东西了，为什么你不出去给别人
？And in this way, now when he left, I felt I really had. Even last year, I started when he's still in the planet.
那么就像去年就是说呢我他还在世的时候呢我都开始在走这一步了
And the last time I spoke to him in Badger
上一次呢在 Badger 的时候呢我跟他说一年前了
He gave me one bag with 108 japa malas
他给了一袋一袋子108个珠子108串珠子一口袋给我
And he ordered me I want you to distribute Harinam all over the world
他说我希望你能够到全世界去传播呢 Harinam 这个圣名
And my Harikatha.
I don't know what Harikatha.
And I'm thinking now, how can I give? I cannot.
我当时想呢，我怎么能给呢
？I'm not qualified.
我没有资格了。
And I've been chastised by very high class Vaishnavas in India.
我在印度呢，被那高阶的 Vaishnava 呢在这方面怪着我了。
That they order you have to give.
他说了他已经命令你了，你要去给。
This is the order of your guru.
那么这是你 guru 的训令。
And if you don't give, you will go to hell.
然后你不去的话做的话呢，你要下地狱。
So I'm thinking everybody in the whole world will criticize me.
我就想全世界人都为了批评我。
He said anybody who criticizes is their own false ego.
那么如果任何人批评那么就是他们的假我了。
And if you are disturbed, this is your false ego.
但是如 果你受到呢啊这个骚扰的话呢，这又是你自己的家伙家伙了。
Because you should make your heart and goal is only to serve and fulfill the order of your desire.
因为呢，你的
the order of your desire.
哦，你的那个目标啊，或者你的心思呢啊，全应该在这里啊，就是服务你雇主的训令。
And by doing that, everything will be guided by him.
那么，如果你这样做的话呢，一切呢都会得到他的指导。
And then, Vrindavana Vilasini, Gurudev says she's the most senior disciple of Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj.
那么，像 Vrindavana Vilasini 弟弟啊，就是说，圣 Swami Maharaj 的一个门徒 ，Gurudev 说他是最有资格的一个。
Gurudev said no one is more senior than her.
也就是说呢，没有人呢比他更资格大啊，资格好了。
She's actually absorbed doing budget all day.
因为呢，每天啊专注在那budget里面啊。
In one little room.
在一个小房间里面。
She always stays there chanting and reading and doing non-budget.
也就是说呢，她总是在那里读书啊，然后呢唱诵啊，在做那个 non-budget 或是啊阅读经典。
She's not making mosques and ashrams for herself.
她做的这个啊庙呢或 ashram 呢，不是为了自己。
Or to have her followers.
或者是呢，有他的啊追随者。
She's only she distributed books for, I think more than 20 years, and her back is damaged from so many books she had to carry.
她呢派书派了二十年了，所以她整个后背啊，因为扛这个书啊，都已经受伤的时间哦。
Gurudev gave her so much mercy.
Gurudev 给了她很多仁慈。
She lived 10 years in the ashram in Gopinath in Mathura.
那么在 Mathura 的庙里面呢，她住了十年啊。
With Gurudev.
Gurudev 在一起的时候。
He's the only one lady that he allowed to live with her Western.
也就是说，在西方门徒之中啊，他是唯一一个门徒呢，姑爹允许在庙里面住过。
And also Shanti.
还有 Shanti 啊。
Shamayani was not allowed.
像 Shamayani 弟弟都不允许的。
He sent her to Rupasanathan Goliama.
哦，当时呢，他呢就说他派到呢 Rupasanathan 庙住啊，就 Shamayani 弟弟。
So anyway, she was very she's very really high in budget. If anybody really wants any good advice. Should ask from her.
如果呢，任何人想好的建议的话呢，哦，应该从他那里去得啊。Vrindavan Vilasini Ji， 他2007年好像给中国奉献讲过一堂课，可能有的人记得。
So I asked what to do. Gurudev gave me this order.
我当时呢问他，我说怎么办呢？Gurudev给这个训练给我。
She said you should go at once and distribute everywhere.
哦，你马上去哦，去派发了。
And she said, you should not think. And I said everybody will criticize me.
我就说了哈，别人会呢批评我。
And she said, "Why do you care what anybody says?"
哦，他说你为什么在乎别人说什么呢
？You should make the goal in your life follow the order of your guru.
你应该哦把这个哦作为你生命的目标哦去追寻孤独的训练。
She said, "Like when Swami Maharaj told us go distribute books."
当时呢，Swami Maharaj呢说哦，你去派书吧。
We didn't know anything.
我们当时也是什么都不知道。
But we went on the street and we distributed millions of books.
我们就上了街道啊，就派了几百万本书啊。
And millions of devotees.Thousands were being made.
那么很多数以千万计的啊奉献者呢，也这样子就哦来了，跟着哦就做了奉献者了，因为这些书派出去。
She said it wasn't us who were doing.
他说不是我们在做，实际上。
It was Krishna doing everything.
哦，是 Krishna 在做。
You should never think you're the doer.
我们不要认为我们是哦这个操作者。
And the same thing for Ananda Prabhu, he was telling me you have to give. If you don't give, you will go to hell.
所以呢，别忙碌碌跟我说了，你必须去给啊，不然的话呢，你会下地狱。
Because this is the order of your Gurudev.
因为这是呢你雇主的训令。
And it's not you who is giving.
那么实际上并不是你在给。
Now people are trying to criticize and make people policy against this.
那么很多人呢就批评了啊，就在此呢啊就就有这些啊，就是说政治方面的啊这些耍这些手段。
Because they want to control everybody.
因为他们想控制所有人。
They want to become acharyas of China.
他们想成为中国的 acharya。
They don't want anybody to come and teach them what is bhakti.
或者是呢，不允许别人来啊教授呢 ，bhakti 内容。
They don't want anybody to come and teach. Why is the different levels of Vaishnavas? Who is who in the world of Vaishnavas?
或者是呢，在 Vaishnava 里面啊，层面啊，究竟是怎样子的
？They want everybody to be subordinate forever.
哦，他们认为啊，所有人都应该在底下啊，永远在底下。
So in this reason, I'm thinking nobody is ever going to make me. Nobody is ever going to control me.
但是呢，我觉得没有人啊可以控制我。
Because I'm only nobody can interfere between my.Order and my desire to fulfill it.
也就是说呢，没有人可以在我的 Guru 的训令和我的愿望啊，想去实现这愿望当中呢，啊，可以介入的。
I know I'm nothing. I'm lower than the worm in the stool.
我知道我也啊一无是处了啊，比呢这个粪虫还低。
But I'm being used like an instrument of my Guru.
但是呢，我是被我 Guru 用啊作为一个工具了。
and it's touching people's hearts everywhere I go.
那么呢，在我所到之处呢，哦，也能够去触动很多人。
From Finland, from Spain, from Italy.
在芬兰也好，意大利还是西班牙，
China, just now,
中国。
Everywhere people crying, telling me wonderful things are happening in their hearts.
那么他们在哭啊，告诉我心中所发现的这些呢奇妙的事情。
Indeed, I also experienced something in Hong Kong.
Indeed, 在香港呢也有所感触。
Is it me? No.
是我吗？不是的。
It is. I know it's all coming from Guru.
虽然这一切呢来自呢是的 Guru 的。
And this is the way it works actually.
那么这也就是呢这个事情能够起效果的一个方式是 Guru 在做。
We should become a flute, empty with no self-interest at all.
所以呢，我们应该成为一个笛子就是说呢，中间呢是空的没有任何东西打在里面。
And then that nectar of that flute can actually go through.
那么这样子呢这个笛子呢这个甘露能够从那孔里面流淌出来。
In this way, we speak Harikatha.
所以这种方式呢，我们去讲述 Harikatha.
And that is all I'm doing.
这就是我所做的。
I have no self-interest.
我没有呢自私的欲望。
Otherwise, I would be in the town chanting 1, 2, 3 lakh daily and being absorbed in my Bhajan.
不然的话呢，我在圣地呢一天呢唱64圈吧，或是120多圈去做我的Bhajan去。
And be serving right next to the pure Vaishnavas daily here in the Harikatha and serving them.
或者是每日呢去呢服务呢这个纯粹的Vaishnava住在庙旁边，然后呢去聆听Harikatha。
But this is a little bit like enjoyment.
但是这也像是一种享受。
You always want to enjoy the Vaishnava.
因为我们想去享受 Vaishnava.
You always want to enjoy Guru.
想去享受 Guru.
That's why Guru Dev said no.
Guru Dev说不行啊。
You go and
去吧，去传播。
So what is really seva?
所以什么是真正的服务呢
？Doing what you don't want to do.
是做那些你不想去做的事情。
But what pleases Guru.
但是呢，却取悦了 Guru 的事情。
Because Guru knows what's best for you.
因为 Guru 知道呢，什么对我们是最好的。
You don't know what's good for you.
但是我们不知道。
So in this way, we're following.
因此呢，我们这样子去跟随。
And the whole world can be against me, no problem.
整个世界都可以反对我，也没有问题。
Guru Dev will bless me, and that's all that matters.
Guru Dev 呢会祝福我这才重要。
So in this way, I'm preaching.
是以这种方式呢，我在传教。
His mission, word for word, everything that I heard from him.
那么这个是一字一字的我从他那里听过的东西。
And his teachings.
他的教导。
So now, I wanted to speak the levels of bhakti because when in one of my tours with Guru Dev around the world.
我想讲述一下共爱的层面的就是说在我一次呢跟 Guru Dev 在一起的时候这个巡回讲经的时候。
He would repeatedly in every country over and over and over speak about this.
那么他会在每个国家都重复讲这些内容，一次又一次的讲。
And I understood this must be very important.
那么我就明白这个内容肯定是非常重要的。
Therefore, also I'm going from every state of China telling this Harikatha.
因此呢，我们在每个地方在中国的每个地方呢讲同样的 Harikatha.
And from Hong Kong to Xi'an.
在香港西安或者是呢杭州。
Which because it's the essence of everything.
因为这个称为呢所有内容精华部分了。
Guru Dev explained how.If one reads all the Vedas, one cannot know what is the essence.
公弟说了，你读遍了《韦达经》，也不能够明白其中精华。
And so, because it's so vast.
因为呢是如此浩瀚的韦达经。
So he's saying you should just try to go to the essence.
所以呢，他说呢，去找精华的地方吧。
The seed.
这个种子在哪里
？The seed of all bhakti.
也就是说，奉爱的种子所有奉爱的种子。
The seed of all the Vedas is actually Om.
就是 Om
Omkar
Omkar 这个音正。
And when this seed opens,
当这个种子开放萌芽之后呢
，it becomes a Brahma Gayatri.
变成了Brahma Gayatri.
And Brahma Gayatri is the mother of all the Vedas.
那么 Brahma Gayatri 呢被称为伟大经之母众经之母。
And in this Brahma Gayatri, it is said Bhargava Devasya Dhimahi. Which means I meditate Dhimahi in the Bhargava potency of Deva Krishna.
也就是说呢，我冥想着Deva Krishna 的这个能量。
And who is the potency of Krishna?
Krishna 能量是谁呢
？It is actually Srimati Radhika.
就是呢Srimati Radhika.
Radhika is the potency of Krishna.
Radhika 呢被称为呢 Krishna 的能量。
So this is the essence of all the Vedas.
那么这就是所有韦达经的精华部分。
And in this manner, Vyasadev, we explained that he wasn't happy in his heart after combining all the Vedas.
那么编撰好伟达经之后呢 ，Vyasadev 呢并内心并不高兴的。
So he wrote his Narada Muni gave him all mercy in his heart, and he realized it, and then he wrote the commentary of all the Vedas, which is Srimad Bhagavatam.
那么这个主 Narayan 的话呢，在他心Narada 在他心中给他启发了，那么他呢觉悟之后呢写下了这个呢这个八卦掌。
So, this actually, the Srimad Bhagavatam is the cream and the essence of all the Vedas.
所以呢，圣典不加瓦呢被称为呢伟达经的这个奶油或者精华的地方。
And this essence of all the Vedas is actually the cream, but like Gurudev says, some people are not satisfied with the cream.
他说有的人吃奶油还不满足啊。
They want turning the cream more and more and more until it gets to the highest essence of all is ghee.
那么呢，最后他们搅拌这个奶油，最后得到的就是酥油最高形式。
And then after ghee, you can't get more. That's the essence of all.
那么呢，如果能再到酥油的话，就不能够再提炼了这已经是精华的精华了。
So all these nine cantos are like the cream.
所以呢，不见瓦堂前面九篇呢，就像这个呢奶油一样。
Tenth canto is like the
ghee. 第十篇就是酥油了。
Especially the five chapters that describe all the gitas of the gopis.
尤其是呢这五篇里面牧牛姑娘的gita 就是描述牧牛姑娘的这个呢篇章的。
Gurudev says you take away these five chapters.
Gurudev 说你把这五篇拿走之后呢。
Bhagavatam is zero.
国家宝藏呢就是空无一物了。
These five chapters are the Purana of the soul.
因为呢，这个五章的话五歌被称为国家宝藏的就是灵魂的这个武器。
At this time, we were in Bajor one festival, like maybe 8 years ago.
大概八年前在Bajor的活动的时候。
Everybody had left.
所有人都离开了。
And Gurudev came out of his room.
Gurudev 呢从那房间出来了。
He sat in a chair like 2 hours.
他坐在呢这个凳子上了2个小时。
Some people from the festival, the organizers would sit in there.
活动的这些组织者呢就坐在那里了。
And he was speaking these things about the Gita.
他会讲到关于 Gita 这些
Gopi Gita.
牛姑娘之歌Gopi Gita.
And he said, he asked one girl, are you teaching all the children in the Gurukula Gopi Gita?
他就问他说你有没有教幼儿园的小生，他可能是幼儿园这个老师吧他说你有没有教学校的孩子Gopi Gita牧牛姑娘之歌。
Gopi Gita is Rasa Lila.
那么这是 Rasa Lila Rasa 的小时光。
It's the five chapters within the Rasa Lila. The middle one is Gopi Gita.
那么呢，我们知道国家宝藏29到33篇是关于 Rasa 的这五章的。那么其中中间那个呢，就是呢牧牛姑娘的歌 Gopi Gita.
So he says, have you been teaching this?
他说你有没有教这东西啊
？No, and he said you should teach all the kids.
他说没有。他说那你就教小孩子唱这个。
Because this is the prana of the soul.
它被称为呢灵魂的prana 气呀。生命之气。
But now secret agents of Kali are coming out saying you cannot sing these things, you cannot talk these things, you cannot hear these things.
但是呢，卡利的代表呢会说你不能读这些不能讲这些。
But I'm just following what I learned from my Gurudev.
但是呢，我追随我 Gurudev 的训示。
Maybe some people were unfortunate and did not give all these personal instructions, therefore they cannot preach like this.
有可能呢，有某些人呢不那么幸运呢，他不能得到呢Gurudev亲自的这种训示所以他不能够传播这东西。
So in this way, the essence is Bhagavatam.
所以呢，国家宝藏呢是精华所在。
And there is actually describing the different levels of bhaktas.
那么这里面实际上描述了奉献者的不同层面bhakta 的不同层面。
So Gurudev explains about the Gyani bhakta.
所以Gurudev呢是解释呢Gyani bhakta这个范畴的奉献者。
Pralhad Maharaj.
就是 Prahlada 大群Gyani Bhakta， Bhakta 是奉献者。
Prahlad Maharaj is a Bhakta which is completely absorbed in the opulence of God.
那么他完全专注在神的富裕神性那面。
He thinks that God is omniscient.
他认为神是全知的。
He is omnipresent.
也是遍头望有的。
He is omnipotent.
也是全能的。
And therefore.God is omniscient, omnipresent, omnipotent, so he's never tired.
所以他从来不有疲倦这么一说了。
So no need to give massage to his feet.
因此呢，不需要给他按摩莲花足什么的。
He's never tired, so no need to give him drinking water.
他也没有疲倦了，因此不需要喝水。
He's never tired, so he's never hungry, so no need to give him food.
哦，没有呢，肚子饿了，所以不需要给食物。
How can he be thirsty or hungry or tired? He's on all greatness.
哦，如果呢，他是哦全然哦伟大哦的神呢，那么呢，他怎么会有哦可能有饿啊，有疲倦的哦口渴呢
？So in this way, there's no seva.
因此呢，这种认知的话，对神的认知呢，导致了就没有服务。那么这个故事呢，就讲到了这个小孩啊，布拉德大军。
We've heard, I'm sure you've heard the story about Hiranyakashipu.
那么大家可能听过这个故事啊，这个恶魔啊 ，Hiranyakashipu。
I never can open it. I've tried to try it, but the water is stuck. So.What happened is that there was a big demon.
有一个大恶魔。
He's called Hiranyakashipu.
他名字叫呢 Hiranyakashipu.
And his brother is called Hiranyaksha.
他的兄弟啊，就是叫 Hiranyaksha.
And he was killed by Vishnu.
那么这个 Hiranyaksha 呢，也被 Vishnu 呢杀掉了。
So, in the form of a boar.
以一个雄猪的形式啊，就是说呢，被杀掉了啊，这个恶魔。
So he hates Vishnu.
因此呢，伊拉克西布呢就非常憎恨啊 Vishnu。
Actually, Gurudev says, Hiranyakashipu is not an atheist.
那么 Gurudev 讲到了这个恶魔 Hiranyakashipu 呢，他还不算是个无神论。
He knows about God.
他虽然知道神。
He believes in Vishnu.
他也相信 Vishnu.
But he hates it.
但是呢，他憎恨 Vishnu.
He wants to kill him.
他想杀掉 Vishnu.
So in this way, he does austerity.
因此呢，他做了苦行。
And he stands in his toes.With his hands up,
他呢就是脚尖点地，然后呢高举双手。
For 60,000 years.
有六万那么多年了，六万年了。
And his austerity was so heavy that the insects were eating his body.
那么他呢这个苦行非常严厉的甚至最后呢这个虫子昆虫啊就把那肉都吃了。
They ate his skin.
皮呀吃了。
Flesh,
肉。
Everything.
一切都吃掉
He just maintained like a mountain of.
他只能最后呢像一个蚁山一样蚂蚁的山
and he was completely pulverized
他已经完全的
pulverized
也就是说身体呢好像不归于呢空无虚无了好像没有身体了
but he maintained his soul there.
但是呢他的灵魂还盘旋在那里还是能够持住了
and he was doing this austerity for 60,000 years
他这样子呢做了这个苦行六万年
The austerity was so strong that the demigods were terrified.
那么他的苦行非常的厉害了，甚至呢半神人都受到惊扰了。
Fire came out of his head.
那么火呢从头上喷起来。
And everybody was starting to worry.
很多人都开始担心了。
So he took the demigods were very worried. So Vishnu Brahma came.
半神人就是说呢就是。主半神很担心的时候呢 ，Brahma 呢就来了。
And he said, I'm very pleased with your austerity. What do you want? Do you want any boon? What do you want?
他说我很乐就是说呢，对你的苦行取悦了我了你想要什么祝福呢
？He said, I want to get a blessing that nobody can kill me, that I am immortal.
他说呢，我想要的这个祝福就是说没有人可以伤害我，我是永恒的。
But he said that is not possible.
但是呢 ，Brahma 说这不可能的。
Because even I die.
因为甚至我都有死的那天。
So in this way, he gave, he said, okay, so grant me that nobody can kill me in the day or in the night.
那么他说了你给我祝福吧，要我呢白天或黑夜呢都不能被杀。
Nobody can kill me in the sky or in the earth.
没有人在空中可以杀掉我或在陆地上。
Nobody can kill me, no beast, no human being.No demigod.
野兽人类和半神人都不能伤害我。
No weapon.
那个武器也不能够杀我。
And no, not inside, not outside.
在屋里面和屋外面呢，我都不能被杀死。
So he said, okay, that's absolutely a blessing. May this be it.
那么他就说了，好吧，那愿你，如愿以偿。
So he threw before he threw water in the with the kamandalu, and then he regained a very beautiful body.
那么这时候呢，布拉玛呢撒一点从 kamandalu 水壶里面撒一点水出去那么他就恢复了这个完美的肉身。
So in this way, he started becoming very powerful king.
那么他成为一个呢非常有力量的君王。
And he was ruling the planet Earth.
统治的地球这个第一个星球了。
But he conquered all the planetary systems.
但是实际上他征服了三界就是所有的星系他都征服了。
The hellish, the heavenly, he was master of all.
包括天堂也好地狱他都是主人呢。
He killed all the Brahminical culture.
他毁掉了摧毁所有婆罗门文化。
Nobody could worship Vishnu.
没有人再可以崇拜主 Vishnu 了。
Nobody could worship do jagyas.
没有人再可以去做祭祀jagya.
He said, I am the Lord.
他说我就是这个主。
Worship me.
崇拜我吧。
So he named himself the Lord of the earth.
所以他把自己呢命名为就大地之主。
And everybody was very terrified of him.
很多人呢都因为他呢感到很惧怕。
Very powerful, many soldiers, many followers.
那么他变得很有力量了，很多兵将，很多呢追随者。
So in this way, he was very powerful.
所以呢，他非常有力量。
But when he was doing austerity for 60,000 years, his wife.
但是呢，在他呢从事苦修六万年的时候呢，他的妻子呢
was pregnant.
也怀孕了。
And she was everybody came and they wanted to kill her.
那么很多人来要杀掉他。
Because they said very dangerous, another demon will come, like Hiranyakashipu.
因为他觉得另外一个恶魔Hiranyakashipu就要来了。
But then Narada Muni came and protected her.
但是呢，Narada Muni呢保护了他的妻子。
And he said, no, this is a very special boy.
他说不是的他腹中的孩子呢是个非常特别的孩子。
He's a devotee.
他是一个奉献者来的。
No need to kill him.
因此呢，不需要呢把他杀掉。
And she took her and protected her and gave Harikatha for 60,000 years.
因此呢，他把那个就天上克西布的妻子带走了给了哈利卡塔六万年呢，也是。
And even he received diksha in the womb.
甚至呢，这个腹中孩子呢，在肚里面呢，肚子里面就接受了diksha洗礼。
And then he came out a very pure devotee.
所以呢，他出来的时候呢，生出来的时候呢，就是一个非常纯粹的奉献者。
He was a Mahabhagavat.
是一个 Mahabhagavat.
So, Prahlad Maharaj, he was a very good boy. He was always absorbed meditating.
那么当时布拉格大君呢是一个非常乖的孩子总是呢专注在呢冥想自尊主了。
He is in Shantara.
但是他情感呢是中性的Shantara.
And his father told him, okay, time to go to school now.
那么这时候呢他父亲说了你该上学了。
And he sat him on his lap.
他坐在他的腿上。
And he told him, my dear boy, now go to school and he sent him to 3 months.
那么他说呢该是上学的时候了我的孩子把他送到了咕噜咕噜就是灵性的导师的学校。
So he went to school and he studied there.
那么在那里呢学习。
And when he came back, his father brought him in his lap and with tears of affection were falling in his head. He was smelling his head over and over with so much love.
那么他呢就是呢一再的闻着他儿子的这个头发一种父爱了。眼泪呢滴落他的身上呢就充满这种爱意。
And he was telling him, my dear son, what is the best thing you have learned?
他说我亲爱的儿子你呢在学校里面学最好的功课是什么？
And then he said, oh my dear father, the best thing I have learned is that sadhu manya sudhavari rehinam sadhu sadhu dhina dhyama satram hitvatva patam griham antakupan bhano gato tham harim ashrayata.The best thing I have learned, my dear father, is that he's telling him, oh, best of all demons, Asurya Bharya.
他称他父亲是魔中之王魔中之杰他说呢
Asura
Bharya.
Asura Bharya.
Bharya.
Bharya is like Haridasa Bharya.
Bharya.
The best.
最好的最顶尖的。
It's also a Hindi word, Bharya, Bharya.
那么也是个印地语叫 Bharya.
Which means best.
最好的。
So he said, the best, all best amongst all asuras.
他说阿修罗中的最厉害的那个阿修罗中的王。
And he felt very proud.
王者 他很骄傲的听了他哦这样的称呼呢。
Yes, I'm the best among all.
哦，是哦，就是人中自己啊，人中之王。
And he said, that Dazuma, the best thing I have learned is that a person who has entered into the family life.
他说那个进入了哦家庭生活的人。
He Vasubandhu Griha, the Griha life, he said, is that person is always feeling embarrassed.
这人呢处境非常尴尬啊，进入家居生活的人啊，处境很尴尬。
He's always embarrassed with so many anxieties because he's always identified with the paraphernalia of his home.
因为呢忧心忡忡啊，这也是因为呢他挂念的啊挂心的呢都是家里面的啊，这个是琐事啊，这些用又就是说所有的这些哦活动的。
He's always identified with the asat, means the things which are not real.Which are not true, which are temporary and false and real.
也就是说呢，他认同那些 asat 的事物哦，就是呢，短暂的哦，非真实的东西。
This means that they are identifying with their husband, with their children, with their grandfather, grandmother, family, and the home, the paraphernalia of the home.
那么他们哦，就是说认同了家里面的哦，就是丈夫啊、妻子啊、父母啊、孙啊、儿女啊。还有家中的哦各种用品的哦这种便利哦。
And this false identification and attachment to this false temporary object.
就是呢对这种哦短暂的事物的一种的哦依附依恋。
What it does is that it hits vatapatam means it completely stops the process of spiritual life.
那么就完全哦终止了呢哦灵性生活的哦这个呢过程了。
So, my dear father, the best thing I have learned is that, and this is like a well. It's in.
他说这个哈、哦、家庭生活呢就像一口井一样。
So, he said the best thing I've learned is that that person should go to Banam, to the forest.
这个人呢、哦，我最好的建议呢，是他应该去到 Banam, 哦，森林里面了。
And from all the Banam, from all the forest, the best is.
最好的哦，森林的哦是哪里呢 ？Banam 哦，最好的是哪一个呢
？Is
就是 Vrindavan 啊 ，Vrindavan。
So once you go to Banam，
那那个人去到 Banam 啊，就是 Vrindavan，Banam 啊。
And Hari take shelter of Hari。
托庇于呢啊，这个 Hari。
Ashrita take shelter of Lord Hari。
也就是说呢，托庇于啊主 Hari。
So when the father heard this, he got furious and threw him off his lap and said, "Who has started this thing?"
那么他父亲听闻后呢，就怒发冲冠啊，就是说呢。把他从腿上啊，整个呢就抛出去啊！他说：“谁教你这些东西？”哦、啊，他就很生气了。那么呢，老师们哦、啊、来了。
Who is teaching them these things？
他老哦、啊，谁教了这些东西
？You're teaching them to worship my enemy, Hari.
哦、啊，你们都教他去崇拜我的敌人 Hari.
I will kill you all.
哦、啊，我要把你们全都给宰了。
He said, "We have not done. We have not done."
老师呢、啊、就说了啊，我们没有教这些东西啊，没有教过他。
So we really, it's not us. We don't know who is teaching him these things.
啊，所以呢，我也不知道是谁教的哦。我实在是不是我们教的。
So in this way, what happened is that they send them again to the school.
那么他们再次啊，将孩子送到学校。
So maybe somebody's coming in disguise.
他认为呢，可能是啊，这个呢，有人乔装打扮啊，混进了学校。
Somebody's coming in disguised and is actually teaching this knowledge secretly.
哦，然后秘密的传授这些知识了。
So in this way, he went back to school.
所以呢，这个孩子呢就回到啊学校。
And now he met with all his little friends.
那么这时候呢，与他所有的朋友们啊在一起了。
And now he is starting to instruct them.
那么开始呢啊教他们东西。
He is telling them, my dear friends, you should all do bhajan. You should all try to do bhakti.
他说你我亲爱的朋友啊，你们都要去呢啊做bhajan啊去做奉爱服务。
And they said, "What? We're little kids. We just want to play."
他说我们只是小孩啊，我们只想玩耍而已。
And he said, "When we're old age, then we can start that process of life."
哦，但是我们如果年纪大的时候哦，老年了哦，可以呢哦，从事这些八正。
And then he said, "No, you should start at a very early age."
但是呢 ，brother 说了哦，你应该从孩童时候，年纪轻轻哦就应该开始。
And he told the example that one has if.For maximum, one lives 100 years.
啊，他说一个人啊，寿命比如说最多活100岁。
He was instructing the children.
他给小孩子教这一课了。
But 50 years are sleeping.
50年就这么睡过去了。
So you only have 50 years left.
只有到十年剩下来。
And from these 50 years, the last 10 years, when you become very old.
后面的十年的话呢，很老了。
Very sick.
哦，疾病缠身。
You cannot walk.
走不了路了。
You cannot eat.
吃饭也吃不下去哦。
You cannot hear. You cannot see.
啊，那么听力下降哦，就是说呢，视力呢也减退。
Very bad condition.
哦，就是说这种身体状态非常差。
10 years. This is the last 10 years are lost.
哦，后面十年呢，算是就是白了，哦，白流失了。
So only 40 years are left.
只有四十年剩下来。
And when you're a child from when 0 to 10,
那么呢，一到十岁呢？
You are engaged in playing ball. Is it what they say? And so many desires,
yeah.
Asking the mother to fulfill.
那么很多小孩子的爱玩啊，哦，要妈妈满足他的愿望。
10 years are lost.
十年也就这么玩过去了。
So only 20 years.
只有二十年。
30 years are left.
只有三十年剩下来啊。
The 10 old age, the child, yeah. So then 30 years are left. 10, from 10 to 20, you're studying and so on.
十年呢，要寒窗苦读啊。
So only 20 years are left.
只有二十年剩下来。
Then you get married.
那么要结婚呢。
And you become very attached to your wife and your children.
哦，那么义父啊，丈夫啊也好，妻子哦，孩子。
Your wife takes you to a solitary place and gives you happiness.
哦，你的妻子带你到那僻静的地方，哦，给你快乐。
And the children come with a very broken language and start to speak to the father.
哦，那么呢，孩子呢，哈，用的啊，这个断断续续的啊，耳语啊，跟那个父亲啊，就是说交谈。
And they become so attached.
他们就这么样子啊，非常依附。
You become so attached to this family life.
哦，依附这个家庭生活的。
How could those 20 years? How could you ever leave?
那么这啊二十年呢，怎么能够离开呀？离不开。
Which is the time for the bhajan? When?
哪有时间呢？做那八卷的灵修呢
？So he said at once from beginning you should, from the very beginning of your life you should start to do bhajan. He told the children.
哦，所以呢，从生命一开始就应该从事八卷，哦，对孩子们这样说。
So in this way, he instructed the children.
哦，他这样子教自己的同学。
From now, from this starting this young age, you should start doing bhajan.
所以呢，我从现在开始的哦，年纪轻轻呢就应该从事bhajan。
So they all started chanting and singing.
所以这些孩子呢就开始唱诵哦，唱歌。
Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama.Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
And then the teachers were so shocked when they saw this.
哦，那么老师们哦，非常震惊了，看到这个场面。
Very afraid.
哦，非常害怕。
And they took him to the father.
就把他带到他父亲面前。
And they sit him on the lap.
哦，那么呢，把他哦放在他腿上。
The father said, "What have you learned in your school?"
哦，父亲说，你在学校学了些什么？
Shavanam Kirtanam Svaranam Vishnu Padanam Savanam Archanam Dasyam Sakyam
Atmanivedanam.
The nine limbs of bhakti.
Svaranam Kirtanam, 聆听啊，唱诵 Svaranam, Vandanam.
Effort, chanting, yeah.
Hearing,
chanting, remembering,
all this. 哦，所有聆听啊，唱诵的冥想啊，就是崇拜四主莲花图啊。祈祷哦，等等。
So the father became furious.
哦，他父亲哦就非常愤怒。
And threw him off the lap.
把他哦也从那哦腿上哦推下去了。
He said, "You're the enemy. He's worshiping my enemy."
他说你已经是我的哦，我已把你目视为敌人啊，因为崇拜我的敌人。
What if there's an axe without a handle can do nothing?
他说如果一个斧头啊没有个斧柄的话呢，还是没有什么用处。
But now,
一个斧头。
You're the handle, and you want.
现在呢，你却呢变成了这个斧头的斧柄了啊！现在你要把我给摧毁了啊，就是说，助我敌人毅力。
He was very upset.
所以他呢很生气啊。
And he wanted to kill him.
想把他杀掉。
So he called all the demons.
他把呢这些呢恶魔们啊招过来。
With three dent.
用三叉戟呀，啊，那三叉戟。
And they want to kill, pierce his body.
啊，想把他身体啊刺穿他了，想杀他。
Kill him.So they could not touch him.
但是呢，这些人呢不能够触碰他。
He was absorbed praying Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
那么他在里面专注于冥想和祈祷了。
Meditating in his Lord.
去冥想他的自尊主。
He's not afraid running here and there escaping.
他没有说害怕就到处跑奔主。
Completely surrendered.
完全皈依了。
Whatever you want, my Lord, if you want me to die, that's your desire.
无论你要什么我的主你要我死我也可以。
And if you want to live, that is your desire.
如果你要我活下去呢也是可以的。
So in this way, they try to.
他们想杀掉他却不能够杀。
They tried to throw him in the boiling ghee.
想把他抛到这个呢就是说呢油锅热的油锅里面树油锅。
Could not touch his body.
但是呢这些东西也不能够触碰他的身子。
They tried to throw him off a cliff.
把他从想从那悬崖上扔下来。
But he was saved by Vishnu.
但是呢他被 Vishnu 拯救。
They tried to poison the snake.
他们想把他投到这个蛇有毒的蛇蛇那里蛇坑里。
But not possible.
但是呢也没有办法。
They try to give him poison in a food. So much poison.
给他剧毒在那食物里面投毒要杀他。
But he offered to his Lord, became Prasadam, he took nothing happened.
那么他把这个供奉给他的主变成了 Prasadam, 后来呢也安然无恙了。
So nothing, there was no way that they could kill him.
也就是说没有方法可以杀掉他。
They put him in fire.
他们把他放入火中。
Fire could not touch.
火也不能伤他毫毛。
So now they were starting to get very worried. The father was becoming very angry.
那么这时候父亲非常的愤怒了他们就很担心了。
Hiranyakashipu. He was furious.
Hiranyakashipu 的话呢就是说怒不可遏。
And he said, "Where is that?" Lord, where do you get your power from? Where do you get your power from?
他说你的主在哪里你在哪里得到你的力量
From the same place that you get your power, my dear father, from Vishnu.
他说呢我呢是从呢你的力量的源头那里得到了我的力量这就是主 Vishnu.
And then he said, yes, your Vishnu, where is your Vishnu? Where is your Vishnu? I don't see your Vishnu anywhere.
原来西部说了你的 Vishnu 在哪里我看不到在哪里。
And he said, he's in the heart of all living entities.
他说他在众生的心中的。
Oh, is he here? Is he there? Is he here? Yes, he's everywhere.
他说他在这吗他在那里吗他说是的他无处不在。
So he said, is he in this pillar?
他在不在这个柱子里面。
And he stroked the pillar.
他用拳头锤击这个柱子啊。
And the pillar broke.
那么柱子呢就破开了。
And came out the very fearful form of Narasimha.
那么这就是呢非常令人恐惧的这个尼辛哈尼辛哈的这个形象。
And he is half lion, half man.
那么这是一个半人半狮的形象。
And he was, he had his hair like.
那么他的头发呢也是呢红色的。
His eyes were red, so angry.
眼睛通红的因为很多愤怒。
And he was, roaring very loud.
那么他呢发出吼叫声就是咆哮的。
And you could see his form like all over the sky.
那么好像呢好似他的身体呢在整个空中整个空中都是他的这个半人半狮的形象。
And then came this, it was not, actually this was not in the day and it was not in the night.
那么这既不是在白天也不在黑夜了。
It was in the sunset.
是在那黄昏时分。
It was not up in the sky, it was not in the ground.
那么他既不在那空中也不在地上。
It was in the air but on a throne, he was sitting on a throne.
那么他这样坐在呢这个宝座上。
It was not inside or outside.
也不在那这个呢屋子外面屋子里面。
It was like in the courtyard, when you enter a house that is not the entrance or inside or out, so it's like in between.
那么正在门槛那个位置就是说也不是屋里也不是屋外。
And it wasn't...In the, it wasn't by any weapon.
也不是被任何武器。
He put it in his lap.
他把它放在腿上。
Just like a mosquito fighting, like mosquito enters into the fire, burns in one second.
那么就像呢，这个蚊子要是进了火里面的话，马上被烧了飞蛾扑火。
In the same way.
同样呢。
Narasimha Dev was, Hiranyakashipu, the demon was trying to fight with the with Hiranyakashipu.
那么呢这个时候呢尼亚克西普呢想跟尼辛哈德决斗了他跟他打。
But he would, he he would just like throw him like a little, like a mosquito, like nothing.
然后他好就把他好扔到一边去哦，就像甩一个蚊子一样哦。
And one time he came and he put him in his lap and with his nails he opened up.
那终有一次呢，他就把他好揪过来了哦，放在自己头上哦，把用爪子啊利爪了，把他的胸膛破开。
The intestines were flying everywhere.
哦，那么肠子的话都飞出来了。
Blood was everywhere.
哦，鲜血哦直喷。
And he is the anger personified of God.
那么他被称为那神的哦，愤怒的哦，这个化身。
Are you scared?
Blood.
He's so cute.
中国的花的。
If he goes,
we're so quiet.
If he goes to
pajama prayer, must be brown.
If he goes to Karika, he should do the.
Brown.
Yes.
他说去朝拜的时候让他演 Brothers 最好的，不安静，被人砍了头都不安静。
He's like a little stage, always singing and quiet.
哦，像一个小圣人一样哦，总是安安静静，是不是？有没有闹过？
没有，
没有闹过。
蛮乖的，嗯。
So in this way, he was not killed by any weapon.
所以呢，他不会被任何武器所伤。
Brahma had given him this boon.
因为呢，布拉玛呢给了这个祝福给他哦。
And he was actually what's the name? He was not disrespected his boon. It was correct.
也就是说呢，这个主呢并没有忌月哦，就是布拉玛给的这个祝福啊，也没有哦，就是说呢啊，违背他的祝福里面的要求了。
Which means it was.He was killed with his, by not any weapon.
也就是说，他不是被任何武器所杀。
He was with his nails.
是被利爪啊，主的呢啊，这个狮爪啊所杀。
And in this way, all the guts came out.
啊，所有的肠啊，里面的胃肠啊，都出来了。
And it wasn't killed by any person or any animal or any demigod.
也不被任何放生人或人类或者野兽啊所杀，受累。
He was killed by the supreme person.
哦，是被自尊性的神手杀害。
So in this way, Prahlad Maharaj was protected by his lord Narasimhadev.
哦，所以呢，普拉德大君呢，哦，被他的主呢，哦，尼辛和德呢所保护了。
And when he came, he asked, "Please tell me, how can I please forgive me for taking so long to come?"
他说呢，请原谅我哦，花了这么长时间啊，去做这件事情来了，来到你身边救你哦。
Then he wanted to offer prayers. He called Shiva and Brahma and all the other demigods, you please come and you first go and give prayers to him.
Who was that? Prahlad. Prahlad 召唤的时候的放生人哦 ，Shiva Brahma 说你们应该哦，首先上前哦，献上你们祷词。
But they were so afraid.
但是呢，他们非常恐惧。
Because he was like.
因为呢，黑阿克西普呢哦，就哦，尼辛和爹子呢还余怒未消哦，还在那啊咆哮哦，还在愤怒了。
In the sky.
在空中了。哦，都是他的影像哦，愤怒了。
Blood everywhere.
啊，四处呢哦，都是鲜血。哦。
It was such a fright, and now people put it in an altar, think it's cute.
啊，现在我们把它放在神台上，以为这个是好玩儿，实际上这个形象是非常愤怒的。嗯。
But they don't understand.
他们不明白这里面的情感。
This embodies the anger of God.
它是神的愤怒啊，化身的。
And it says that whatever deity you worship, you will take the qualities of that deity.
那么你崇拜哪个神像，你就会获得那个神像的那个品性。
So if you worship Narasimha, you will get this anger mood.
那么你崇拜尼辛和爹，那就会获得这种愤怒的哦品性了。
Of course, he's transcendental, he's God.
但呢，他是超然的哦，他也是神呐。
But still, he's like anger personified.
但是呢，你要知道他是愤怒的化身。
So in this way, the demigods were even afraid because it was such a he was so angry. He became so angry that they were.That his little devotee was being harassed by Hiranyakashipu.
那么他因为非常愤怒啊，令到放生人都惧怕啊，这种愤怒的，因为他的小奉献者啊 ，Prada 呢，哦，被这个恶魔哦，如此的哦骚扰了。
That he was so upset that he was so angry that everybody was afraid to offer prayers.
那么呢，他非常哦愤怒啊，所以令到众人呢都不敢上前去哦向他祈祷。
So in this way, what he did is that nobody wanted to go.
哦，所以最后呢，没有人敢上前了。
They said, "You go first, you go first."
每个人都推脱啊，说你上去吧，你先上去啊。
So Prahlad Maharaj went first.
最后呢，普拉德大君呢，就是勇当先锋。
Maharaj was not afraid at all.
他一点都不害怕。
Because it's like a big lion, you know, the lion is like attacking all the animals, so his little cub, he's like his little cub.
啊，那么一个狮子或老虎啊，这个猛兽了啊，虽然攻击别人的时候非常凶猛啊，但是呢，如果自己的虎仔啊，如果自己的狮仔啊，那么呢，它就会啊很疼啊，会叼的，会舔的。
So in this way, the little cub was Prahlad. He was not afraid at all.
所以呢，这是小狮仔啊，就是 Prahlad， 他不害怕啊。
He's his lord.
因为这是他的主啊。
But he gave him a garland because.
那么主要呢，他献一个花好呢，也是为了呢，平息他的怒气，那个花。
So in this way, then the demigods came and offered also prayer.
然后呢，那个放神人就来了就献上他们的祈祷。
But that Hiranyakashipu insisted.
那Hiranyakashipu呢，就一再坚持了。
I want to give you a boon.
我要给你一个祝福。
Any blessings, whatever you want.
任何一个祝福你都可以要啊。
He said, I don't want anything. Why are you cheating me?
那么呢，现在布拉德说了，我不想要任何东西啊，你为什么要骗我呢？
I want nothing of, and you're making me like get karma involved in this cycle again of.
他说呢，你要我要东西，就证明呢，就是说让我陷入这个 karma 啊，就是不断重复的啊，这个轮回里面啊，这交换。
So he said, okay, so in this way, if I have to ask for something, I want that my father will be liberated.
但是如果我真要什么东西的话呢，那我就期望我的父亲能得到解脱。
And he said your father has already been liberated.
他说呢你父亲早已经解脱了。
And in this way, Prahlad was very happy.
Prahlad 很高兴了。
He became a king.
他成为了这个王国的君王了。
So this is the story of Prahlad Maharaj.
这是 Prahlad 大君的故事。
He's a Gyani Bhakta.
他是 Gyani Bhakta 这个 Gyani Bhakta 就是。
So all the Bhagavatam is describing the different types of bhakta.
实际上，国家宝堂呢描述的就是不同层面的奉献者，当里面也就相关他们的不同奉爱不同层次奉爱。
Then it explains another bhakta that comes after this.
那么在此之后呢，另外一个奉献者。
Which is the Shuddha
bhakta. 就是呢 Shuddha bhakta.
This is.Ambarish Maharaj.
那么这就是呢 ，Ambarisha 大君。
And he was a king.
他是一个王。
Shuddha Bhakta means he's a pure devotee.
Shuddha Bhakta 的意思就是纯粹奉献者。Bhakta 是奉献者的意思。
He is using all his senses in the service of the Lord.
他将所有的感官投入到对至尊主的服务里面。
He's a king that had so many palaces, so much wealth, and so many queens.
他呢是一个君王的，那么就是说呢。就是说府宅呀，到处都是他的宫廷府宅王妃就妃嫔啊，成群的皇土的辽阔。
But he used all his senses in the service of God.
但是呢，他还是这么高贵富裕的一个国王呢，还是将所有感官用于服务。
He had one deity, Krishna.
他有一个神像就 Krishna.
And he would actually worship himself.
那么他自己本人呢，就亲自去服务这个神像。
This Krishna is Brajendranandana Krishna.
那么这个 Krishna 呢，就是 Brajendranandana Krishna.
Means Krishna in Vrindavan.
Vrindavan 的 Krishna 他崇拜这一组神像。
So in this way, his Ishtadev is higher than Prahlad Maharaj's Ishtadev.
那么他呢崇拜的神像Ishtadev 呢就高于呢 Prahlad 的 Ishtadev.
Because he has service.
因为他有服务。
And he is using his eyes only to see the Lord.
他眼睛只是用来光瞻的至尊主。
He's using his nose to smell the tulsi leaves that are offered to the feet of Bhagavan.
用鼻子呢就嗅这个呢供奉给国家白莲花族的这个托西。
He's offering the, he's using his ears only to hear Harikatha.
他的耳朵仅用来聆听 Harikatha。
He's using his mouth only to take prasadam and to speak Harikatha.
那么他的嘴巴呢只用来呢讲述 Harikatha 和呢荣耀 prasadam.
And he is, although he has so many servants.
那么尽管他有很多仆人
He himself is cleaning the floor of the temple.
那么他自己呢本人呢却清洁庙宇。
With his knees and his hands.
用他的膝盖还有呢他的手扫地。
He's worshiping Guru Puja Chitakuti.
那么他呢也崇拜呢崇拜神像，排骨井。
And he is using his feet to do parikrama in all those sacred places.
他用自己的脚呢，来呢朝拜。
And in this way, he uses all his senses in the service.
所以呢，他把感官都投入服务。
So one day there was the. He is a very pure bhakta, so he's observing Ekadashi.
哦，那么他是一个纯粹的 Vaishnava bhakta， 所以呢，他呢也呢遵守 Ekadashi 戒食。
And in this way, he's only, he's fasting completely, no water.
那么他呢是全戒没有水的。
His queen is also very qualified.
那么他的王妃呢也是呢非常有资格这个王后。
She's also doing nirjan.
他看到了他也做了这个全戒。
So, what he does is that he would not take prasadam until all the brahmins. He invites many many brahmins and he sits them to sit down and he gives them prasadam first and after they have all eaten, then he will take.He would break his ekadashi.
那么他破戒呢？就是说呢，那天要宴请婆罗门很多婆罗门。等他们吃完了后呢，他会去吃他们的鲫鱼吃剩的，然后呢用这个破戒。
Because the kshatriyas means the kings, the rulers, or the fighting class, which are the kings, they always worship the brahmins.
因为呢过往年代的话呢，kshatriya就武士阶层或君王阶层呢，他们都是呢就崇拜呢婆罗门的服侍婆罗门。
So in this way, suddenly came Durvasa Muni.
那么突然间呢，就是那多瓦萨穆尼就出现了。
Durvasa Muni is a rishi.
多瓦萨穆尼是一个 rishi 一个圣者。
Muni.
或者说一个穆尼摩尼的。
Which is always, he has a very fearful look.
他有一个很令人惧怕的一个面相了。
He has his long dreads.
比如说那头发卷的长的。
He is always he's yogi.
他是一个瑜伽师。
So yogi has very much mystic power.
瑜伽师有很多神通力量。
But he's famous because if anybody gets him angry, he curses them.
但是他最著名的是他的坏脾气任何人呢惹毛了他他就诅咒别人。
So everybody's afraid of him.
所以每个人都害怕他。
So he came to the assembly in the uninvited.
那么他呢就是不速之客不邀自来的那么一个出现在了他们聚会中了。
And he came and Ambarish Maharaj was very happy that he came.
Ambarish 大君呢很高兴他来了。
I said, please, please sit down and take prasadam.
他说，请你坐下来荣耀不杀人吧。
And he said, one minute, I will go take bath.
他说，你等一分钟我要去呢沐一下浴。
So he went to take bath.
那么他就出去外面沐浴了。
And there he was taking snan.
他呢在那里就沐浴是那
sacred river,
在一个圣河里面
and he was ready to chant his mantras,
他准备好了念他的曼陀了
but meanwhile it's time for param means there's a time for breaking the ekadashi
那么这时候呢是该破戒的时间了
if you don't break in this time then it's aparad
那么如果不在恰当的时间念破戒呢就是冒犯
it's offense
一个冒犯了
so he was very worried what to do
所以呢安布利什大君呢就非常担心该怎么办呢
So he asked his advisors.
他就问他的这个呢顾问宫廷顾问。
His ministers.
他的丞相啊。
What to do? I don't want to disrespect this Brahmin.
怎么办呢我不想呢不尊重这个婆罗门。
But if I don't break the Ekadashi now.
但是呢如果现在不破 Ekadashi 戒的话。
Then I will be disrespecting Bhakti Devi.
那么我就会呢就是说呢不恭敬的Bhakti, 幸运这个奉爱女神呢 Bhakti Devi.
I will be disrespecting Ekadashi.
我会不尊敬的Ekadashi.
So, he didn't know what to do.
所以呢他不知道该怎么办
So this is the teaching, two teachings actually he gave Gurudev when he spoke this Katha in Mathura.
那么在Mathura呢Gurudev讲这个Hare Katha的时候呢给了两个教导。
That I received, that I took from him.
这是我呢从他那里接受的了。
That he said that if one has to, in this,What is this situation?
如果一人在这种状态中这种情况处境
and one has to choose between you know like offending a Brahmin or let's say disrespecting or disrespecting Bhakti like who should you always give more priority?
那么呢就是说呢能冒犯呢婆罗门呢或者是说呢不恭敬一个婆罗门呢还有呢冒犯就是不恭敬奉爱那么哪一个更重呢孰重孰轻呢哪一个更应该优先呢
If you offend or if you disrespect a Brahmin
如果你呢不恭敬一个婆罗门或冒犯一个婆罗门呢
this will be a reaction in this life or this body.
那么呢这个呢肯定这一辈子呢有现世报啊，或者在身体
but if you disrespect bhakti,
但是如果你不恭敬奉爱服务
then this is harming because bhakti is in next life you will be damaged.
因为呢这就会给我们造成一种伤害啊，甚至来世啊都会有这种伤害。
So Gurudev gave the teaching that you should always try to think it's always more important to respect bhakti.
所以他说呢，更重要的是啊，尊重 bhakti 奉爱。
So in this way, he said, I have to protect my bhakti.
所以他说呢，我要恭敬啊，我要保护我的奉爱服务了。
Still, I don't want to disrespect the brahmin.
但是依然我也不想啊，不恭敬的这个婆罗门。
So they said, if you drink one drop of water.
他们说呢，如果你饮下这一滴水。
This is like breaking.But not breaking at the same time.
那么这就像破了戒的啊，也算是不没有破。
Okay, it's like breaking the his brush, but it's not disrespecting the brahmin because you're not eating.
也就是说呢，你啊算破戒，但是没算吃东西啊，像吃的也算不吃啊，就破了戒，但是不算吃东西，这样呢就没有不恭敬这个婆罗门。
So he took the drop of water.
所以呢，他也就呢喝了这点水。
But what happened?
一滴水啊，那么这会怎么样呢
？Immediately, Durvasa Muni, who was in the river, he was chanting. He knew.
啊，多瑟穆尼呢正在河里面啊，正在唱曼陀啊，沐浴呢啊，他就马上知道了。
Because the Muni, the rishis, Vaishnavas, they know everything.
因为呢，穆尼啊 ，Vaishnava 或者是呢 ，Yogi 呢，他们是知道那所有一切的。
No need to internet, Yahoo or email.
不需要呢，这个 email 啊，写信的。
Immediately they know everything.
他马上就心里面收到信息了。
Actually, it's really funny. I want to tell one story about one time there was one Indian that came to Gurudev and
有次呢有个印度人啊来见 Gurudev
he was asking talking to Gurudev he said you know but now there's so much technology we have internet
他说现在呢科技很发达啊有因特网啊已经有网络
we have internet and an internet for one second we can connect to the other side of the world
啊一瞬间就能够跟啊世界另外一端连接了
so how can this compare at all with the Vedic with the Vedas
The
Indian asked
them. 他说这个跟韦达经呢，能不能啊，里面的东西能不能媲美呢
？Is there anything? I mean, the Vedas is so like mystic and all, but what? How can you compare something like this? So he said.
古德呢就说了。
Gurudev said, "Do you know what Srimad Bhagavatam is?"
你知道圣典薄伽瓦堂是什么吗
？So then he said, "Yes, yes. My grandmother used to tell some stories."
啊，那这个人呢？印度人说的，我祖母呢，经常给我讲一些故事。
She said, "Oh, she's an intelligent woman. She knows."
哦。
And then he said, "You can tell them that he was Lord Panda's grandmother."
那么他是一个有智慧的人呢，哦，他知道这些东西。
And he said that, then Gurudev said, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, there's one story.
那么古德讲嘛，圣典薄伽瓦堂呢有一个故事。
That there's one king.
有一个国王。
Parikshit Maharaj.
Parikshit 王。
And he came and he wanted to. He was very thirsty.
他当时口很渴。
So he asked the Brahmin, "Give me water."
他当时问一个婆罗门啊，就说你能不能给点水
？But the Brahmin was absorbed.
但这个婆罗门呢，已经专注在冥想里面。
He didn't have any external consciousness.
没有外在自觉的，实际上。
So for this reason, the king Parikshit Maharaj put a dead snake on his shoulder.
那么这时候呢，这国王 Parikshit 王呢，就把一个死蛇啊。就挂在他的身上了。
But the king, the Brahmin was so absorbed, he didn't even notice.
那么这个婆罗门呢也很专注啊，也不知道啊什么发生了什么事情。
Because the king thought he was being neglected.
因为这国王觉得我是被忽视了，啊，被撂一边去冷落了，啊。
So Gurudev said, in that moment, hundreds of kilometers away, the son of the Brahmin.
那是呢，数百公里之外呀、啊，这个婆罗门的儿子。
The son of the Brahmin, a little boy called Shingad Rishi.
Shingad Rishi, 啊，一个小孩儿。
Five years old.
五岁而已啊，比他还小。
He was immediately he knew.
他马上就知道了，哦、啊，自己父亲啊遭到不敬对待。
Immediately he knew that his father had been dishonored.
也就是说，他父亲啊被不恭敬的对待，他马上就知道。
He had been garlanded with a dead snake.
而且知道呢，哦、啊，他是被用蛇啊，就挂在那啊脖子上。啊、这种方式。
So he cursed that in 7 days, snake bird will come and bite Parikshit Maharaj and he would die.
那么他就诅咒了，他说呢，7天之内啊，7天了， 那么这个蛇鸟呢就会来啊，就把那帕利奇王咬死。
So within seconds.
所以在瞬间。
In the there were in the river in this forest there were thousands of rishis gathered.
那么呢，在森林中呢，就瞬间呢就有很多圣人云集了。
They were not only they knew.
他们不是说知道。
Within seconds.
是在瞬间啊，马上就知道了啊，不是说只是知道而已啊，慢慢知道啊，瞬间。
Not only they knew, but they were gathered there.
而且呢，不仅知道，已经行动的啊，开始呢啊就聚集了啊，聚集在一起。
From hundreds of kilometers.
从那个不知道多少多少百公里之外啊，就全部聚在一起了。
So then Gurudev told that scientist, Indian scientist.
那么呢，顾立言就告诉这个印度科学家。
He said, just look.
你就看吧。
Our internet vedic system.
啊，我们的啊 ，internet vedic system。伟达时代的英特网。
That means within seconds, not only you don't need every Vaishnavas know everything.
真正的维生老师是知道一切的。
I know, I have learned a little bit of this in Mathura.
在马图老呢，我就学了关于这些东西，我就学了点。
With Gurudev,
跟 Gurudev 在一起。
With Premananda.
哎呀，Premananda Prabhu 在一起，我就知道点啊。
Actually, Premananda Prabhu taught me how to communicate with Gurudev.
啊，那么是培曼那个部呢，告诉我怎么跟Guru Dev交沟通的。
That's the way the Vaishnavas communicate.
这也是我们圣瓦沟通的方式。
They communicate, it's not by words.
他们的沟通不是通过言语。
Not by machine.
也不能通过机器啊送信。
It's transcendental.
是呢啊，超然的沟通，他们用这种方式，
so、
我们要学实际上。
So in this way, Durvasamuni immediately knew.
所以呢，Durvasamuni呢也马上就知道。
That Ambarish Maharaj had taken this, Ambarish Maharaj had taken this water.
Ambarish 那君已经吃了这个水，喝了水了。
And what he did is that he became furious.
他就很愤怒，就很愤怒。
And he came and.
他就回来宫殿皇宫中了。
He said, "You hypocrite! You're not a Vaishnava."
他说你这个虚伪虚伪之人你并不是一个 Vaishnava。
You taken the water without.Honoring me,
你没有呢恭敬我就先喝了水因为我是个婆罗门。
He was furious.
所以他就很生气。
And he said, and he pulled out one of the jyoti, his this dread, you know.
他把那头上的一撮头发就扯下来了。
And immediately came out a goddess, not goddess, demoness called Krishya.
他就把那一个女魔火魔就创造出来了。
Fire.
Yeah.
Fire.
Yeah.
And he made her come to destroy Ambarish Maharaj.
那么他想造这个魔来那个杀掉 Ambarish 那君呢。
But immediately came a Sudarshan Chakra.
但是呢，很快马上苏达山这个神给就飞来了。
And the Sudarshan Chakra destroyed the demoness.
然后呢，把这个女魔杀掉。
And immediately, the Sudarshan Chakra start chasing Durvasamuni.
那么，而且苏达山呢，立即追逐这个呢，Durvasamuni.
Durvasamuni. And Durvasamuni, what did he do?
苏达山怎么做呢
？When the demoness came of fire.
当这个女魔苏达山当这个女魔出现的时候
What did Ambarish do?
Ambarish 怎么做呢
？He just stayed like.
他只是在这里
He said, "Well, God, if you want me to die, it's your desire."
他神呢，你要我死那也是你的愿望。
If you want me to live, it's your desire.
你要是让我活呢也是你的愿望。
Completely surrender.
完全皈依的心态
He didn't do anything more.
他没有为此的多此一举的
But in this way, then after, what happened?
但是稍后呢
What did Durvasamuni do?
Durvasamuni 又怎么反应呢？
Durvasamuni start running.
他四处逃窜拔腿就逃了。
Running, where can I go away from this Sudarshan Chakra chasing?
我怎么能够逃脱苏达山的追索呢
？The Sudarshan chasing everywhere.
沿途苏达山呢无处不去。
And he went to Brahma.
他去到主布拉玛那里了。
And the Sudarshan very close, slowly, very slowly coming.
苏达山呢靠得他很近的，但是又很慢的跟着他，好像没有直接马上飞过去，把他杀了。
Yeah, usually Sudarshan comes fast and cut them.
因为呢，苏达山是非常快的这种武器的，他一下子飞过去那里就死了。
But this Sudarshan is going slow.
但是呢，这个苏达山看起来有点慢飞的，紧追在后面而已。
And And he's always behind.
而且他总在后面啊，他就一路跑。
Very hot.
很热了啊，灼烧了。
He goes to Brahma.
他去到主布拉玛那里。
And he says, please help me.
请他帮帮我吧。
This Sudarshan Chakra is chasing me everywhere.
他说这苏拉神呢，就是说呢，追着我啊，到处啊追着我。
And Brahma says, what can I do?
主布拉玛说啊，我该怎么办呢？我能怎么办呢？
He says, I'm not independent.
我也不是独立的啊。
I'm just a servant of Krishna.
我不过是啊 ，Krishna 的一个仆人。
Krishna only with a little movement of his eyebrow.
哦 ，Krishna 呢，只是用他的啊，就是说呢，啊眼啊眉毛啊，就是说动一动。
He just lifts his eyebrow.
啊，只是呢，挑动一下眉毛。
And he destroys the whole universe.
可以说把整个宇宙都毁了。
So I'm also destroyed with it.
我也呢啊，在其中我也被毁了，灭顶之灾了。
I cannot do anything.
因此呢，我也无能为力。
So then he goes running to Shiva.
那他就跑到西马神那里。
Mahadev.
Mahadev. 啊。
And he tells me, please help me, help me. This Sudarshan Chakra is chasing me.
他说呢，请帮助我，苏达闪呢正在追逐我。
And he said, well, what can I do?
哦，西马说了，我能怎么办
？I'm also just a servant of Krishna.
哦，我也是 Krishna 一个仆人，Vishnu 仆人。
Vishnu. So I would say, I cannot do. I suggest maybe you go and ask Vishnu.
哦，他说呢，我建议你还是找这个主人Vishnu 吧。
But actually, please go. It's getting too hot.
哦，请你离开我这里不然的话这里都很热被苏达闪烧得很热。
So then he goes running to Vishnu.
他就跑到Vishnu 的跟前。
And he tells me, please help me. I beg of you.
哦，请我哀求你请帮助我吧。
This Sudarshan is chasing me everywhere.
哦，这个苏达闪呢追逐着我。
And he's saying.Ihambhakta paradinohi asvatanta ivatriva sadubhidrastan vidayubhaktar bhakta janapriha. He says, my dear Brahmin.
他是我亲爱的婆罗门啊。
Ihambhakta paradinohi asvatanta means I am not independent at all.
他说我根本的一点独立性都没有。
I am completely dependent on my devotee.
我也完全就是说呢，依赖我的奉献者了。
I cannot do things independently.
我不能够独立行事了。
Because my devotee, my devotee only, I live only in the hearts of my devotees.
我只住在我奉献者的心中。
And the devotee lives in my heart.
奉献者也住在我心里面。
Therefore, I cannot do anything.
因此呢，我不能为力啊。
What to speak of my devotee?
不要说我的奉献者了。
The devotee of my devotee, Bhaktar Bhaktar.
我奉献者的奉献者啊，就奉献者的仆人。
Are very dear to me.
对我来说，都是我非常珍爱的人啊。
So, just like if one, you know, I forgot this, but then there's another verses. There used to be really many verses, but I forgot unfortunately.、But the other one.Which says Jitaragara Putrapta, which says the devotee has left their Jitaragara, their house.
我的奉献者抛弃他们的家。
Putra, their son.
他们的儿女。
Their husbands.
丈夫。
Their relatives.
或者是亲属。
Their family, everything.
家人都放下了。
They have left everything for me.
为了我放弃这些。
How can I neglect them?
这种人我如何能够抛弃呢？能够就是说呢，忽略呢
？How can I protect them?
我怎么会不保护这些人呢
？So for this reason, he said, I suggest you go back to Ambarish Maharaj.
所以呢，我建议你还是回到Ambarish大君跟前吧。
And you ask.
请求他。
To ask to
forgiveness. 去呢宽恕你吧。
So he went again to Ambarish Maharaj.
他就再次跑到Ambarish大君面前。
And Ambarish Maharaj was standing there.
Ambarish大君还站在那里。
For 1 year.
一年时间还站在那。
Praying.
在祈祷了。
So Sudarshan Chakra, don't kill him, don't kill him, don't kill him, please don't kill him.
苏达闪呢请不要杀掉他，请不要杀害他。
So that the only reason he was not killed at once by the Chakra.
所以呢，之所以呢，他们立即被苏达闪呢就是说命归黄泉不被苏达闪杀掉。
Was because he was praying.
因为呢就是呢这个Ambarish大君为他祈祷。
Not to be killed.
让他不要遭此就是说遭此一遭就是说这一劫。
When he saw the greatness of his devotee,
所以他看到了他奉献者的伟大之处。
He followed his feet and asked, gave pranams and asked for forgiveness.
那么这时候呢，多闪就向他顶拜请求他宽恕。
But the king was very embarrassed. No, no, why you give me pranam? You're Brahmin.
这个国王呢非常尴尬他说呢。 你是个婆罗门哦，怎么能够哦，就是我能怎么受此大礼呀、啊？哦，就你顶拜我。
So please don't.
哦，请不要这样子。
Please sit down and take a
请哦，坐下来哦，跟我一起哦，荣耀，我们要荣耀和上等的哦。
So in this way, Ambarish Maharaj, Durmasa Muni was so impressed by this.
啊，那么这是啊，就多拉萨穆尼呢，就对此的话呢，哦，非常感动的哦，深受感动。
He gave blessing to Ambarish Maharaj.
他祝福了 Ambarish 大君。
Then he will eternally be glorified.
也就是说，他会永远的哦，被人荣耀称颂，啊，被世人啊，就流芳百世
哦。
因此呢，他的名字呢，记载在这部经典里面哦，是哪部叫法？
Glorify the Shuddha Bhakta.
啊，去荣耀呢这样一位的 Shuddha Bhakta 啊，纯粹奉献者。
So higher than this Bhakta is a Hanuman.
比他更高的哦，是呢 Hanuman.
Hanuman is Premi Bhakta.
他被称为呢 Premi Bhakta.
He has actually, so much love for Ramachandra.
哦，那么他是对主 Ramachandra 的哦，有很强的爱。
I wish I could talk to them.
需要跟你们说话啊，在这边说不上两句。
I cannot know language. So. Okay, so. In this way, then, yes. I have some gift. Some CD.
他给个 CD 给你，给张 CD， 你那也听不了。
我放不了，我不得放，我自己给他放。
哦，是一个人住是吧？
他这样子，他跟女儿在一起住，他年纪大了，他这种东西不大会操作。但是他每天念诵。
She could not pray with this. No, she don't know how to use this technology. No, this new thing.
She
叫你女儿给你放。
他不相信了。
And her daughter is again her daughter.
女儿不在。Anyway, take it. She can still take it.
拿着吧，没事的，就省会保佑你。叫你女，你不一定要叫你女儿，叫别人也可以。
You can get a little CD player.
你怎么怎么是毛病吧？你怎么？
没事。
哈哈。
那路有点远，有两个小时。
Because she's a devotee, her sister is here.
她好像是朋友。
Yeah, think so. Not like a
80
fair problem.
70
She's 80 years old. Depends on the daughter. And a little bit controlled.
Last
time she was sick, I think, coming back from the coma. In Vrindavan. So the daughter is not very sick. Although she's so old, like 79, 80. Take 2 hours to go back. So she has
TV. Everybody got TV? I will
give. 你们每个人都有了吗？
稍
微稳定一下，稍微调整一下。
So then， And Ambarish Maharaj is higher than him.
但是 Ambarish 他就应该比他更高。
But he's only a bhakta.
但是呢，却是一个奉献者。
But he's higher.
更高一点啊。
Because he has service mood.
因为他有服务的心绪。
And because his Easter Dev is higher, is Vrindavan.
而是啊，还有一点呢，就是他的 Easter Dev 啊，他崇拜的神像更高啊，是 Vrindavan Krishna.
And Hanuman, he is Premi Bhakta.
Hanuman 呢是称为 Premi Bhakta.
But he has, actually he has, he doesn't have to do any sadhana, he sees that, he's perfected, this is his body.
那么呢他呢不需要做什么大的能了啊，就是说灵修啊，他已经啊是个完美的啊 Siddha, 就是说他是完美的啊同游来的。
He's an eternal associate of God.
主呢永恒的同游。
So in this way one time he was, this past time, about the kumkum. That Sita was putting kumkum in her head.
那么有次呢他看到了 Siddha 呢啊 Siddha Devi 呢在头上啊擦这个kumkum粉啊做工粉啊。
And in this way,He asked him, why are you putting kumkum?
他就问哦，为什么你头上要抹这个哦kumkum粉呢？
And he said, because this kumkum, it will make Ram's life longer.
他说呢，就是说呢，作为妻子啊，他擦这kumkum的话呢，会令到呢啊，主人的生者更加长寿，哦，增加他丈夫的寿命。
So then one time they were all in an assembly.
那么有一次呢，在一个大的聚会里面
，All the kings.
所有的国王都到场，主拉玛春德也在场。
And then Hanuman enters.
Hanuman 呢就进了场地啊。
Full of kumkum all over his body.
哦，身上呢都是kumkum粉啊，红粉啊。
And everybody starts laughing and laughing.
其他人都嘲笑啊，都笑起来了。
So what happened to you?
他说你是怎么回事
？He said, why you do that?
哦，干嘛抹的一身粉
？Well, because Sita said if she puts a little bit of kumkum, you will live a long life.
哦，现在说了哦，现在 David 说了，你呢？哦，他头上挂一点点哦，猪笼粉呢，你就能够长寿啊。
So I want you to live a very long life.
哦，我希望你能够活哦，千千万万岁，很长很长寿命哦。
So you was all right.
所以呢，他把身上哦全部抹上了猪笼粉啊，一身都是红粉。
So you see the deities in India, Hanuman is all red.
哦，所以呢，我们看到汉马的神像啊，一般都擦的红的，啊、哦，哇，红色的。
So then, higher than him is the Prema Pardava, five Pandavas.
那么比他更高的是啊，五胖的五兄弟。
And they are from these five Pandavas, Arjuna is the best.
在胖的五兄弟中呢，阿朱呢是最好的，啊，最佳的一位。
And this Bhakta is actually very intimate friendship with Krishna.
那么这些奉献者呢，跟 Krishna 呢啊，就是关系啊非常友好的啊，像朋友。
So this very intimate friendship, what happens is that they will eat from the same plate.
哦，那么这位亲密的度呢，表现在什么？他们在同一个碟子里面啊吃东西。
They will sit in the same seat.
啊，坐在同一个座位上。
They will sleep in the same bed.
在同一张床上躺着可以。
When the head here, feet here.
有一个人呢头朝这边啊，另外一个人头在那边啊，脚在那边。
So in this way they are very intimate friends.
所以他非常亲密的朋友啊。
But of course not as intimate as the friends in Goloka Vrindavan.
但是呢，不像呢 Goloka Vrindavan 这些牧牛童哦、啊、那种朋友那么亲密。
Because Arjuna would not climb in the shoulders of Krishna.
阿朱呢不会说呢爬到 Krishna 的哦、啊、肩膀上去。
Or jump in top of Krishna and wrestle and say I'm stronger than you.
或是呢啊摁他的啊，就是说摁。把他啊爬到他身上说呢啊我啊就比你啊更厉害啊我战胜你了。
So that friendship Sakya Rasa in Braj is different than that Sakya Rasa with Arjuna.
所以呢这个呢 Braj 的啊这个朋友情感呢跟 Arjuna 跟 Krishna 情感还是稍微有些不一样。
But anyhow very close relationship.
但是依然还算是比较亲密的哦、啊、情感。
So even Arjuna will give order to Krishna, you carry my chariot, you drive my chariot.
那么甚至呢，阿朱那呢都呢啊命令他啊说呢啊你给我呢啊拉这个马车。
And he's carrying.
他就呢啊就驾这个马车给他。
So, but when he showed his universal form.
但是当他展示了宇宙形体给他看的时候。
Then he became very astonished. astonished and his mood changed towards Krishna.
那么这时候呢，他非常惊讶了，他对 Krishna 情感呢也稍稍有转化转变。
So a very very intimate relationship with Krishna now broken a little bit.
那么现在呢，本来亲密的关系呢，现在就有点断了。
When he saw the opulence of the universal form of God,
他看到了神啊，这种呢富裕的宇宙形象的展示。
He's thinking, Oh, your supreme Lord.
哦，他说你是至尊主。
I have done offense to you.
我对你做出了冒犯啊。
I have eaten in the same plate.
我跟你曾在一张碟子里面吃东西。
Slept in the same bed.
在同一张床上睡的。
I have done offense.
我已经冒犯你了。
And he was feeling like this.
然后他就有这种感受。
Very like now he could never have this relationship again like before.
那么他再也不能恢复原先那种情感。
This is also like Devaki.
那么就跟 Devaki 一样的情况。
Vasudeva Krishna, Vasudeva and Devaki are the parents of Krishna when he appeared in Mathura.
那么我们知道呢，当 Krishna 显现在 Mathura 的时候呢，Vasudeva Devaki 是他们的父母。
Because Gurudev explained that Devaki Krishna.Appeared like Vishnu in the jail of Vasudeva and Devaki.
也就是说呢，这个 Devaki Krishna 啊，就 Devaki 的儿子 Krishna 呢，他是显现在呢，comes out 的啊，就是在地牢里面啊，他是呈现为 Vishnu 的形象啊出现。
But at the same time, in Vrindavan in Gokula.
但是同时呢，在 Vrindavan 在 Gokula 这个地方
，Krishna was born from the womb of Yashoda Mama.
啊 ，Krishna 呢啊，就生至呢。也受到妈妈的腹中，从她肚里面生出来。
So there are two different Krishna.
所以有两个不一样的 Krishna。
So when Krishna goes back to Mathura to kill Kamsa,
Krishna 呢重返呢 Mathura 去杀 Kamsa 的时候
，He finally once goes to his mother.
最后来到父母母亲跟前了。
And he wants to embrace her.
他想拥抱他母亲啊。
But he cannot.
但是却做不到。
Because he feels.
因为他感觉到了。
Devaki wants to embrace Krishna.
Devaki 想去拥抱 Krishna.
Devaki wants to embrace Krishna.
他想去拥抱他。
But she cannot.
但他却不能够做。
Because she has this mood of Krishna as Vishnu.
因为呢，他有这种心态说 Krishna 是呢Vishnu.
So he's God.
他是神呐。
So there's some reverence.
因此呢，有这种敬畏心在这里。
So it's her son. She hasn't seen him for 15 years.
那么是他的儿子十几年都没见了但是呢，现在呢在眼前呢，还没有向前拥抱。
She wants to embrace.
想去拥抱。
But Aishwarya Sutila Prema, this friend mixed with Aishwarya is ruined.
Ruined.
Yeah, ruined.
那么呢，就是呢，当混的 Aishwarya 恭敬的那一面的这种 Prema 这种纯爱呢，就被毁了。
The pure relationship of love is ruined.
也就是说呢，这种呢纯粹的爱的关系呢就被毁了。
So in this way, Arjuna has this very intimate friendship with.
所以 Arjuna 呢跟Krishna 呢有这种亲密关系。
Now, but higher than all is Prem Atul, which is Uddhava.
那么比他们 Arjuna 五兄弟更高呢是 Prem Atul 就是 Uddhava 跟 Krishna 的关系。
He's the topmost Bhaktava.
在奉献者中他是最高的 Uddhava.
And He is the best.
最佳的最好的。
Krishna, actually, he went to kill Kamsa, and he went and all the Nanda Baba went with the bull cart and Balaram.
那么呢，实际上 Krishna 呢去杀 Kamsa 的时候呢，Nanda 呢也驾着牛车带着 Balaram 大家是一起去的Mathura 的。
And he was taken by Akula in the chariot.
那么Krishna 呢就坐在 Akula 的马车上这样走。
And he went to kill Akamsa.
去杀 Kamsa.
And he killed him.
把他杀了之后呢
？And he killed all his demoniac followers.
把他们这些呢邪恶的同友也一并杀掉。
But now it is time to go back.
现在开始重返的回去的时候了。
So I don't know if I should continue or leave this for tomorrow.
我不知道是该讲下去还是明天讲，你太晚了吧，你们要不要走了？
Tomorrow is the best day.
明天最后一天。Tomorrow we start earlier, 9:30 to 12:30. Like we keep some time in between. Maybe 1:30 we leave. You know? So in between.
So Uddha, he is the best Vaishnava.
Uddhava 呢被称为最佳的 Vaishnava,
Bhakta,
奉献者。
So he is, Krishna is, he sees Krishna in the roof.
他呢有次呢在呢这个宫殿的顶楼上就是屋顶上呢看到 Krishna.
But okay, before this, I want to explain one thing.
在此之前我解释一下一点。
This is important, very, very important. Siddhanta that Guru gives actually.
老公那给很重要的 Siddhanta.
That when you know Nanda Baba, Krishna kills the Kamsa and the demons.
那么 Krishna 呢杀死了 Kamsa 这个恶魔。
And now it's time to go back.
这是该回去的时候了。
Nanda Baba is waiting in the border.
啊，南德大君呢就在那交边界那地方等着他。
The borders of Mathura to go back.
也就是 Mathura 跟好明道人的交界地方啊，等着他。
He's waiting 1-3 days.
等了一两就是说两三天了。
But Krishna is coming.
Krishna 还没来啊。
So then he is Krishna coming, and then he is saying, "Okay, Krishna, let's go, let's go."
后来 Krishna 来了那么他就说了，哦 ，Krishna 我们走吧，走吧。
And he said, "Father, my father, but I have to stay a little bit here, like 3 days."
他说哦父亲哦他说我还要在这里留三天嘛。
I have to console my mother Devaki and Vasudev.
我要去安慰我的母亲Devaki, 还有Vasudeva。
And he said, well, no, you come. Balaram can stay, but and console them, then you come with me.
他说呢Balaram可以安慰他们你还是跟我回去吧。
And Balaram says, no, I cannot live without Krishna.
Balaram说我不能够就是说离开 Krishna。
So he insists,So what to do?
所以怎么办呢
？He has to because Nanda Baba knows also.
因为 Nanda Baba 也知道。
He says if I will take Krishna by force, I will be like a very cruel, heartless person.
如果我强力的把 Krishna 拉走的话呢那我就算是心肠很残忍的人了。
Because he knows that Devaki and Vasudev have been tortured for 20 years because of Krishna.
因为呢，他知道Devaki 呢，因为 Krishna 的话呢，被折磨了20年时间。
You know.They were imprisoned in the jail.
他们被呢囚禁在监狱中。
They were put in jail, and the 6 children were being killed.
前面生的六个儿子呢都被杀掉了。
And in total, they suffered 20 years.
一整呢20年呢都在受苦了。
So for 20 years, they had to suffer.
这20年他们都在承受着痛苦。
So, and now, how can Krishna go back?
现在他 Krishna 怎么能够就这样走呢？
So in this way, he said that I have to stay for some days to console and I will go back.
我呢要留下一段时间父亲两三天安慰一下他。
Also, actually, Gurudev explains that it is Nanda Baba also feels I cannot take him, otherwise I would be very cruel.
那大君也觉得自己呢有于心不忍的就是说呢 要把他带走的话呢确实呢也心肠有点刚硬的。
So for this reason, he decides, yes, okay, I will go back.
所以呢他这样子决定他说那我就先回去吧。
So Krishna gives him one load of clothes.
Krishna 呢将一捆的衣物绸缎衣物给他了。
Silk cloth and very fine cloth, royal cloth.
这皇家的衣服就是那种很高贵的衣服了就丝绸做的。
And jewels.
还有一些珠宝。
And buys him in the chal and says, "Go, please give to Maya."
绑了一捆就说了请把这个带回给母亲Maya.
Just so that.
也说的
Maya. So then, he's thinking, "How can I do this?"
那么 Nanda 就说了就想了我怎么能够这样做呢
？Nanda Maharaj is thinking, if I give this to Jashoda Ma, she's gonna tell me, "Have you sold my son?"
如果把这个礼物带回去给Yashoda说了他会说你是不是把我儿子给卖了卖了拿了这东西回来。
So then, he's thinking she's gonna become upset.
他肯定就是不高兴了。
But anyhow, he gave.
但是现还是呢Krishna就给了。
So then, Nanda Baba goes back.
南大君就回去。
And when he gets to Vrindavan, he sees Yashodama and he says, "Where's Krishna? Where's Krishna?"
哦，所以呢，他看到Yashoda妈妈的时候呢，Yashoda妈妈说了，哦，Krishna在哪里？到哪里去了
？And he gives them, he gives the cloth.
他就把衣物呢给他了。
He opens the bundle. She opens the bundle.
Yashoda就打开这个捆衣服嘛，打开来看。
So what? You sold my son for this cloth?
他说呢，你把我儿子卖了就为了这些衣物。
And then, she become very upset.
他就非常不高兴。
She stopped crying and crying and crying.
在那里哭了。
So much she cried, so much she cried, she became blind.
她哭得很厉害，很伤心眼睛都哭瞎了。
And then the Baba is like a statue paralyzed.
南哥大君呢，也像一个木雕一样
，so very pathetic, very pathetic scene.
所以这是一个非常凄惨的一个场景。
So Buddha explains why did not Buddha, why didn't Krishna go back?
不如再讲到为什么会少没有回去呢？为什么没回 Vrindavan 呢？
So there are many reasons.
有很多原因的。
He explains that the first reason is that Devaki and Nanda Baba, Devaki and Vasudev have been tortured for 20 years because of his fault.
那么因为他自己的过失了会少的过失呢，那么Devaki Vasudeva 承受了20年的苦心啊，就是说痛苦了。
So then Krishna feels I have to reciprocate.
所以呢，Krishna觉得呢有责任去回应他们就有一种交流了。
They have suffered so much.
因为他们受了很多苦。
So another reason is he says that also there was a king. The king was called Ugrasen.
那么有个国王叫 Ugrasen。
But Kamsa put him into jail.
Kamsa 的父亲后来被 Kamsa 呢囚禁到监狱中了。
Krishna killed Kamsa.
Krishna 杀了 Kamsa 之后呢
？And now again put
Ugrasen as a king. 又立了Ugrasen做王了。
But now he's very old.
但是Ugrasen年纪很大了，很老了。
He cannot rule.
你没办法统治王国。
So he tells, I cannot rule. I'm very old. Please.
他说，他就告诉Krishna 说呢，他说我年纪那么大也没办法做这个统治
So he's telling Krishna, please, you be the ruler.
请你成为这个统治者吧。
You should rule Mathura.
你应该做马图里的王统治马图拉。
They named him the ruler of Mathura.
所以他们把他命为就是说降免为王了，马图拉的。
They vote and they all vote to be ruler.
也就是他们都投票都选了库什做王。
So in this way, he's feeling he has this obligation, this responsibility.
他觉得自己有这个责任在身
So he this is one reason he feels the obligation. I have to rule Mathura.
他有这个责任觉得我应该统治马图拉。
I have to reciprocate with my parents.
跟我的父母双亲有个交代有个交流了
Also, then Buddha explained why then Krishna doesn't go Vrindavan is very close. Why doesn't he just go one day and then come back like this?
他说呢，那为什么库舍不马图拉Vrindavan那么近，怎么不隔天差五的去看一下呢回去Vrindavan呢？
So Buddha explains that the gopis are so much dying and the Brajavasis in fire of separation.
布迪说了，因为那牧女姑娘Braja 居民的话呢，在这种分离自我中奄奄一息的好像要死掉了。
That is like a pot burning in the fire, very very hot.
就像一个锅就是说呢，烧得很热很热，在火里面。
And if you throw one drop of water,
你把一滴水洒下去
，What would happen?
什么样子的？
Exactly. That's how Buddha goes.
马上就蒸干了发出嘶嘶声了。
He goes, and then this is the fire separation is not going to cool down.
因为这种分离之火呢不会被熄灭仅那么去看一下什么的，不能熄灭它的一天两天的就是这样打一滴水下去只是发出嘶嘶声不能灭这个火。
So in this way, the gopis will just and the Brajavasis will just be like.
那么这时候呢，观者居民呢就只会发出这种嘶嘶声
They're always going to be suffering, thinking Krishna's going to leave us in any moment.
他们总会因为这个念头受苦了觉得 Krishna 会随时会离开我们。
They're always be worried Krishna will go.
Krishna 会离开会走了。
And also Krishna, he goes to many kingdoms and kills many demons everywhere.
而且 Krishna 呢去到不同的这个诸侯国，杀了很多恶魔。
So before he goes to his mother and asks her blessing.
每次呢去到母亲面前都要祈求母亲祝福的。
And the mother gives him blessing.
母亲也给他Devaki 给他祝福。
So imagine now.
那么现在呢
？If he says, "Okay, I'm going to go to Vrindavan."
你想象一下，如果他跟他母亲说我要去Vrindavan。
The mother will, Devaki would be very upset.
The 个情人会哦很哦不愉快。
That he will, she will not be blessing.
不会给他祝福。
Because she will become very upset that he's not going to come back.
哦，会很担心哦，他不会再回来了。
And also then Buddha says, so okay, then just make it simple. Bring the Brajavasis and live together in Mathura, then everybody can be happy.
那么呢他就说了啊，那你把 Braja 居民带来吧哦，带到 Vrindavan, 那到Mathura去啊，大家住在一起不是开心吗？
But, for example, in Mathura, in Vrindavan, Krishna, the father Nanda Baba tells Krishna, bring my shoes.
但是在 Vrindavan 呢，比如说啊，Nanda Baba会告诉 Krishna, 你把我鞋子给我拿过来。哦，那么呢，为啥就把呢哦这个木屐呢哦顶在头上呢，很重啊，好像都哦头不动了。
And bring it on his head, which is a sign of respect.
那么、哦、还能顶在头上，这是非常恭敬的啊、哦、做法。
But on the other hand.
但是另外一方面呢
？What happens is that on the other hand is if this Brajavasis go to Mathura,
如果 Braja 居民啊去到 Mathura 的话
，the Mathura Vasis they come like the father Vasudev, he comes and he sees Krishna's shoes and he gives pranam to them.
哦，那么像 Vasudeva 那样哦 ，Krishna 的父亲呢，他见到 Krishna 的鞋子都要礼拜的。
Because he sees his Vishnu.
因为他把他看作 Vishnu。
And all the queens, all the princes there, they all give pranams to Krishna.
哦，那么这些啊、王妃们哦、公主们哦、Mathura的王妃公主们，也要顶礼 Krishna.
Like Vishnu.
好像 Vishnu 一样。
They don't seem like a little cowboy.
没有把他看作小牧牛童啊。
Like an ordinary boy, like the Brajavasi.
哦，像哦 Braja 居民眼中的一个普通小孩小男孩。
So in this way, there is a difference.
因此呢，这是有区别的啊、哦，心态啊、哦，心绪。
So now, if this Nanda Baba, that Krishna carries the shoes of Nanda Baba. Now, if they're in Mathura living together,
如果 Krishna 呢，就是说他头上顶着 Nanda 大君的哦鞋子，那么现在如果他去到 Mathura 哦，跟他们住在一起。
And they see if Vasudev and Devaki and all these people from Mathura see how they're giving so much respect to Krishna's shoes, but now they see that. Krishna is carrying the shoes of Nanda Baba.
那么 Mathura 居民啊，像 Vasudeva、Devaki 和其他人哦，都这么恭敬 Krishna 的鞋子啊，现在发现 Krishna 呢在顶着别头上顶着别人的鞋子。
They will be shocked.
啊，会不会 shock 啊？
Shocked.
他们会啊，非常震惊了。
They will think, what is this? You know.
他会觉得啊，这是怎么回事呢？哦，这非常不恭敬啊。
Or the princes all give so much pranam to Krishna.
而呢，这些公主们啊 ，Mathura 的公主呢啊，这么尊重 Krishna 啊，顶拜他。
But if they see that the gopis are abusing Krishna and insulting,
所以看到呢哦，牧牛姑娘们哦在责骂 Krishna 哦，有时候呢赶他走了。
This will be very big contradiction.
然后这会形成很大的一种冲突。
Rasa
方面冲突。
This will be called rasa bhas.
这个称为 rasa abhas.
Means a bhas, a mixture of rasas.
Rasa 的哦混杂，啊冲突。
Not possible together.
这种呢就这种两个人都不能住在一起的。两种心绪完全不一样，住在一起啊、哦，不行的。
So this is the reason why Krishna not coming back.
所以这就是为什么 Krishna 不啊、哦、不啊、哦，就是说不回去了。
So we will stop here, and tomorrow we speak about the last part of Buddha and the message.
也就是说呢，哦，我们明天再讲了，哦，今天讲到这儿，好、哦，明天讲Buddha拜的信息。
Good, everyone.
Hello.